I went kicking and screaming into loosening my hair. I had a bunch of hair, but there was a little spot in the back that started to gain steam, and it made it so I had to cut my hair so it all matched the length back here in the back.
Right.
And so I had a five head going for a while, right when you started, and I took a good hard look at myself, and I said, just go ahead and do it. And I took it all the way, but not bald, you know? And then when the pandemic hit, I couldn't get to see Gregory down in Pigtown. Had to take matters into my own hands. Started cutting my hair. And I took it all the way down.
You eased your way into it. And I hate to say this, and you know, I didn't notice because it was so short before to go bald. It didn't seem like a big jump.
Not a big jump after taking it down to right close to the scalp.
Yeah.
But what was I worried about? Because there's a new survey from Super Drug Online Doctor, and they say you might as well just shave it down, guys. They surveyed 1,000 women and men from the U.S. and the U.K. They found that being bald, it's not the date and death sentence that we might have thought it was. 42% of the women, I mean, that's almost half, 42% said they found bald guys sexy. So, 51% of women in the U.S. said that they'd be hot for a bald guy. 51% got over top of the halfway mark. 90% of the ladies, 90% in Gen X, Generation X, I'm in that. I just squeaked in. 1965 to 80 is Generation X. Millennials, 81 to 96. You got 9 out of 10 in that category said they'd be up for hooking it up with a bald-headed guy. So
yeah, it's definitely more prevalent now in entertainment to see
damn Skippy
bald guys that are viewed as sexy.
Yeah.
And it's got to be terrifying for a man to, thank God it's not a female, well, it is a female thing. Thank God it's not as common for women. We get all the crap, right?
Oh, yeah.
Thank God you guys got something.
My mom, you could see through right to her scalp. She had a thinning hairline for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't try and cover it up, spray on, or wear a wig. She owned it. But that's
really
why my brother was bald and right out of high school. I kept mine for a lot longer than he did. Yeah, but he used that Afro Sheen blowout kit, and it did what it said it was going to do. It blew all his hair out. I didn't use that. But when you were in high school at his age, you needed to have a big-ass Don Cornelius fro if you were trying to pull some ladies.
Yeah. Sometimes people say that, oh, I gave myself a perm and then it all fell out and it never grew back.
Yeah.
I don't think it's that the perm made you bald. It's that you were probably going to go bald the next cycle.
Yeah.
And it just sped things along.
When I was dyeing my hair blonde, it blew out a patch right here. You leave that stuff on too long and it smells like bacon burning. It's like, take it off. It's only been on for 5 minutes. It needs to stay on. It burned.
Oh.
The Beetlejuice look I was working with for a year. So when it comes to what women are looking for in a dating partner, looks came in fifth behind personality, sexual chemistry, health, and location.
Location is the first one.
It's either the first or the fourth one. I think location is probably first because you got to be geographically desirable.
Okay. I mean,
if you're
too
far away.
I guess, well, it's a basic requirement for sure.
Not
single
with your friend.
Would be another one.
Your friend was dating somebody up in Canada. How'd
yeah,
that
they're
work
still
out?
Talking. They're still talking, but it's not because the border's
location
closed.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Especially right around now.
Well, and yeah. It's a basic requirement. Location and being actually single, I would say. That's crazy that looks is number five. Wow.
Way down. Mickey this weekend said, hey, Kirk, how long have you been shaving your head? I said, since the pandemic started. He said, looks good.
You got
a good shaved head. So I guess that's a compliment.
So kids can have weird shaped heads, babies.
Oh, yeah.
And moms buy those helmets. Have you ever seen them?
A helmet for the kid?
For babies, yeah.
For babies.
If your little baby has a flat back of their head, you're supposed to like turn your baby when it sleeps so that their head doesn't get flat. And if not, it's like a $1,200 helmet. and it's for your specific child. You can't just buy anyone.
Right. Yeah.
And it reshapes their skull so that it's not a weird size or shape.
Now entering the game, number 42, little Billy Jones with his helmet on.
Right. Well, I know somebody very close to me that had a kid with a flat back of their head, and she's like, should I get the thing? It's like, yes, you out of your mind, get it.
Unless you want your kid to be slapped on the back of his head for the rest of his life.